For studying rough weather, the National Weather Center in Norman, Oklahoma is at the center of the action. Inside, researchers are working on what is called the Hazardous Weather Testbed. Participants work with the latest computer models and cutting-edge forecasting techniques.
It's about bringing practitioners or operational forecasters together with researchers and computer modelers, a very broad community, and bringing them all together to focus on the next generation of weather prediction.
Typical work days start after noon. It's taken all morning for the sun to heat the atmosphere. Warm air rises, and rising air mixes it up. That churning air is what provokes severe weather, and that's what these experts are studying. They're also getting ready for the future. A brand new NOAA weather satellite is on the horizon. Once launched, it will take its place in space and offer a wealth of major new capabilities.
GOSAR is going to be unbelievably helpful, whether it be lightning data or cloud. We're going to have so many more different channels in terms of visible or infrared that will help us in terms of forecasting and figuring out where that severe weather is going to happen.
GOSAR may be the latest in a long line of satellites, but its new capabilities will be more than just a tune-up.
So it's going to be like putting on glasses compared to what we have today. So this is going to be a great improvement to our methods right now.
Rough weather used to be the great unknown, something always over the horizon and capable of arrival without warning. But times are changing, and with hands-on training, like that of the Hazardous Weather Testbed, and new technology like GOSAR, forecasting will continue to develop into one of the only disciplines that can actually foretell the future.
South Oklahoma City, be big hail and lightning would be my biggest concern.
After all, knowing tomorrow's weather profoundly affects decisions today.